Hello everybody, my name is Ashalata Nandyal.
Today I am going to teach value education subject of 4th standard, lesson number 2. Topic name is Mr. and Mrs. Jackal. Once in a forest there lived Mr. Jackal and Mrs. Jackal. They had a nice family with beautiful kids. Often they would take out some time and go for short trips. Mrs. Jackal always had a very high opinion about herself. She used to boast of her intelligence and treated her husband as a fool. Actually, Mr. Jackal was simple and never opposed his wife for such a bad treatment that she gave to him. He always thought that he would someday prove that he is not what has been thought about him. It was a nice green forest where they lived, and the place did not have any wild animals, so their kids could also play peacefully. One day, they were taking a stroll on the banks of the river, enjoying the cool breeze. While walking, Mr. Jackal told her husband that she was very intelligent and had plenty of intelligence. Poor Mr. Jackal nodded and asked in a low voice, "Plenty? Plenty means how much?" Mrs. Jackal immediately replied, "It can be counted as 100. "Oh, then I have only one," said Mr. Jackal. As they were taking the stroll in the cool breeze, they were also discussing about their children, their future and themselves. They were looking here and there and enjoying the scenery. Suddenly, they heard the roar of a lion nearby. Hearing the roar, they were terrified. Mrs. Jackal got frightened and asked her husband, "Did you hear what I heard?" Mr. Jackal said, "Yes, dear, I also heard the same." They could not understand what to do but continued walking, and then they heard another roar of the lion. It seemed coming from a place closer this time. Now, Mrs. Jackal got more frightened and asked her husband to find out some way to escape from that danger. Mr. Jackal said, "Dear, I have only one intelligence. What I can do?" "You have plenty of intelligence. Actually, you are a genius and you should use your brain so as to save our lives in this time of danger." On this, Mrs. Jackal replied, "Half of my intelligence left me soon as I heard the roar for the second time. Let me try to use the other half part of my intelligence." In the meantime, another roar was heard, and this seemed to be coming from a place very close to them. Mrs. Jackal started trembling with fear and said to Mr. Jackal, "Dear, I think all my intelligence has gone. I am unable to think anything. Now you have to think about our safety. Please do something." Mr. Jackal remained quiet and continued taking his stroll. The lion was roaring again and again. This time it seemed coming from just near them, and they really could see a lion standing in front of them. Mrs. Jackal started trembling severely with fear and said, "Dear, I cannot think anymore. My remaining intelligence has gone." She began to hide herself behind her husband. Mr. Jackal said, "Okay, let me see if I can think of something." The lion stood close to them and said, "I want to eat both of you because I am very hungry." Mr. Jackal mustered lot of courage. He first greeted him respectfully and asked about his welfare. Then he said, "Sir, we are at your service. But I am sorry, we may not make you happy or satisfy you with our old lean and thin flesh. Would you like to try our 5 fat children who are at home? Let me bring them too, so that our whole family makes your meal quite lavish, and then I am sure that you will be satisfied after eating all of us." Mrs. Jackal was really surprised by what was happening in front of her. She was wondering what her husband was going to do. The lion felt very happy to hear all this. He immediately permitted Mr. Jakal to go home and bring their 5 fat children. Mr. and Mrs. Jakal greeted him respectfully again and walked fast towards their home. The lion got so convinced that while waiting for a sumptuous meal, he fell asleep. After going for quite a distance, Mr. and Mrs. Jakal took a sigh of relief. The danger had gone and they were at ease. Ultimately, it was Mr. Jakal who used his intelligence to win over the situation with his cool mind. After this incident, Mrs. Jakal never boasted again about her intelligence and never treated her husband as a fool. Whatever can be used in adverse situation is intelligence. It can never be measured or counted as 100 or 200. Moral of the story is, intelligence helps in adverse times. Now it is homework for you children. Take a notebook and write the question and answer yourself. Answer the following questions. Question number 1. What was Mrs. Jakal proud of? Second question. What was the character of Mr. Jakal? Third question. What have you learned from the story? Thank you for watching this video.